Hi, sir.
Hello, Onya. Any more worries?
Yes, sir. There are quite a few.
Okay. What is it?
It's the factor that we need to consider for the pipe fittings provided in Appendix D of B31.3.
Yeah. That's correct. So what's the problem?
In plain terms, I just don't understand the physical significance of the factor, or am unable to visualize the factor and its need with fittings.
Okay. That's a general problem. Not a big issue. Do you know that when you model a pipe into the analysis software, how is it taken up by the software?
Yeah. When I model elements from node to node, I build up a piping system. This piping system is then checked for the various loadings and deflections.
Yeah. That's right. But what I intend to ask is, when you model pipe, do you actually get deflections and loadings pertaining to pipe?
Yes. This is what it should be. When we model the pipe and account for various loadings on it, we shall be getting deflections that of the pipe itself. Isn't it?
Actually, each pipe element modeled is idealized to a beam element. And the formulation of loadings and deflections are the same as that for the beam element. So, when you model a straight pipe, the software idealizes it to a straight beam and applies the formulation of the standard beam deflection as per the loadings on it.
Okay. It means that our graphical pipe modeling corresponds to beam modeling in the background. It seems interesting.
More interesting part is yet to come, and it's related to the question of yours, visualization of SIF and its need. But this question is of general concern that needs to be clearly applied. Hence, if you are also among those who want to understand the intricacies within these SIFs and its importance, I'd suggest going through Markel's work. Meanwhile, you can click on the link provided below to understand some of the underlying basics, technicalities and usage of the stress intensification factors, which are put in the form of questionnaire displayed here. In order to receive the correct answer to these comprehensive questions and see your responses against the others and few eminent ones within the industry, you need to subscribe to this channel. So do subscribe to receive the correct and widely used practices in the piping industry. Now, coming back to you, Onya. When we have straight pipe into the entire system without any fitting, say like straight pipes directly joined to the equipments like reactor and condensers, we won't have any problem of SIF, as all the straight pipes can be easily idealized to straight beam element, and this idealization is valid in practice.
So what happens to this idealization when fittings come into the picture?
Simple. Say to idealize an elbow which is actually a curved pipe, we need a curved beam. Isn't it?
Yeah. You sound right.
But problem lies here. Theoretically, the straight pipe's deflection can be simulated by straight curve beam's deflection, and in practice the same deflection is observed practically. But when the deflections of the curved beam are related to that of the curved pipe, you start observing deviation.
Means to say?
Curved pipe's behavior, i.e. our elbows, does not perfectly correspond to that of the curved beam.
If they would have corresponded, then we won't be having SIFs. Am I right?
Absolutely right. In the same way, if the straight pipe's behavior would have deviated from that of the curved beam, we would be having a factor for that idealization also.
That sounds great. Now I'm able to understand the things to some extent. Shall I proceed ahead with your questioners and see whether I'm able to align my thoughts in the same direction?
You can have my questionnaire, and for your responses you need to click on the link furnished below. Do subscribe to my channel to receive correct responses and others' responses. In-depth details are furnished within the questionnaire.